welcome. This is Melissa Armour with Stock Swooshing and Reviewing the SPY here today. Again, everyone's been talking about this, saying it's a V-shaped recovery, it's a V-shaped recovery. This isn't a V-shaped recovery to me. It really wasn't even back even here when we started to drift off, when I saw we're going to fall on March 3rd. I'm going to take it back to December. Here. You see the difference between this? That's a V. A V is a sharp sell-off down, then a sharp immediate, pretty much immediate, like as soon as it makes the pivot point, a sharp immediate move up. So this is selling and this is buying, okay? So a V is a sharp move, just look at my arrow, sharp move down, sharp move up. So the move down is fast, the move up is fast. That's not what you've had here at all. My God, this is not what you've had here whatsoever at all. I mean, so this is absolutely not a V-shaped recovery at all. And that is also, you know, playing into my factoring, looking at this as far as reading the gaps is what I'm saying to myself. I look at them, I rate them, I read them, the bullish gaps, the bearish gaps. And I know there's more selling coming into this market. It's a question of when. It would be better for the health of the market if we had sold off harder, faster. We would have already recovered by now. We might even be back up closer to the highs by now if we had done that, but we didn't. So this is definitely not a V-shaped recovery. It's not just looking at this right even now. So when people say that, they don't know how to read technical analysis and charts. They don't understand gaps, and many people don't. In fact, many people in the 3 years I've been doing television, people don't understand gaps and don't even understand the importance of gaps. Gaps are very, very important in charts, bullish gaps and bearish gaps. Not every gap is critical, but every gap that rates well per my system is critical to play on. Although the ones that don't rate well, you can still gain information from those gaps. Now, for those of you that don't know what a gap is buying or selling that happens in the pre-market and the post-market, okay? So it is very, very important to understand that information. What is the buying that's going on? Who's doing the buying? Is it retail traders buying the market, or is it institutional traders buying the market, or institutional money, okay? But anyways, very, very different look here than what I'm seeing. So we'll see how this week plays out. It's a very critical week for the market because with some big names reporting, earnings season is in full flux, but this is really when we get started this week with the big names. So I'm excited to see what happens here. And don't forget also what I said about the banks. You're not going to have a recovery in this market or a bank up at new highs without the banks. The banks are trending down, 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 down. The banks are in a downtrend. Just going to pull up one here really quickly. This is JPM. It's in a downtrend. I mean, this just, look at this chart. Good luck, everyone. If you're interested in learning how to analyze and read gaps, email me at melissa@thestockswoosh.com. Have a great day, everyone. And the next Golden Gap course is May 2nd and 3rd. You don't want to miss it. Now's a great time to trade with me.